Hey, what's up guys? It's Abby Andrew and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm finally going to use some footage I used for my Tank Girl cosplay to make a tutorial on how I made this costume. This is a costume that I wore to Comic-Con last year, which was actually my first time at Comic-Con. Part of the reason I've always wanted to cosplay Tank Girl is because, as you guys know, I have alopecia, so I'm bald myself, and Tank Girl is often depicted with patchy sort of hair. So even though I'm completely bald, I figured I could do some sort of really cool hairstyle by gluing different hair pieces onto my head and creating a very kind of like punk rock patchy hairstyle look that Tank Girl often wears. Something that's really fun about making a Tank Girl cosplay is that you can get really creative with it because in a lot of different depictions, she's wearing very different outfits. So you can kind of make any sort of mixture of like ripped clothes, dirty clothes, jean, camo, leather, well fake leather of course because we gotta keep this vegan, but any sort of like punk rock, like dirty, grungy kind of style mixed together. You can get a really, really cool Tank Girl cosplay. So the route that I took was I kind of sort of modeled it off of one of her looks in the Tank Girl live action movie, which is really awesome. And then also some components of the comic book versions of her. So I'm not gonna do a full makeup tutorial in this video. If you guys do want a Tank Girl makeup tutorial, please comment below and let me know. But basically I did a very simple makeup tutorial and then just added some components to make it more Tank Girl-esque. To attach the hairpiece, I just used these clip-in bangs that I actually glued to my head sideways. I have a whole other tutorial on how I did my Tank Girl hair, so if you want more details on that, you can go check out that video. But basically, I just used spirit gum to attach it to my head, and it lasted for the whole day. And then to kind of make my makeup a little bit more Tank Girl style, I put on some like bandages on my face. I used some of this rock climbing tape that I have, and put that on my face like bandages as well. To top it all off, I used an eyebrow product, but you can really use anything of like a darker kind of shade that looks like dirt. And I used that to add like some sort of fake dirt to my face as well, because she always looks like she's covered in like grime and dirt. So now to get into the costume. The really cool part about putting together this costume is that a lot of it actually was thrifted. So first, starting with the shirt, this was originally just a plain white t-shirt that I got at a thrift store. It was probably $5 or less. And I cut off the sleeves, cut off the neck, and I also put this Tank Girl bullseye on. I used a stencil to make the bullseye like a perfect circle, and I just used some red and blue fabric paint. The t-shirt was a bit big on me, so I did tie it in the back just to make it a little bit more fitted. These shorts are also thrifted, but you can use whatever pair of shorts. They're not really a key component of the costume, but then to make them a little bit more Tank Girl style, I added these two belts on top. Then for the shoes, these are some knockoff Doc Martens that I got from, I think, Shein for really, really cheap. Surprisingly, they're really not that bad, but now I own a pair of the vegan Doc Martens, so I'm probably going to end up selling these on my Poshmark if anyone wants to buy them. They also do run a bit small, so I got them in a size 8, and they feel like a 7.5, so they were a little bit uncomfortable for the day, but I managed to make it work. Then I also have these fishnets, and then I added these socks that are kind of like athletic-style socks that I also got from Shein. So for accessories, I have these two belts that I added because Tank Girl's always accessorizing with stuff like that. And then I also put on a whole bunch of bandanas. So I have one bandana that's like a black and red checkered bandana, one that's a skull bandana, and then these black and red bandanas. When I put together this costume, it was right around Halloween time, so there was a Halloween store open near me. So a couple of the pieces I did get from the Halloween store, like this green army helmet, and this pack of fake plastic bullets. These were actually a huge pain because they kept falling apart on me while I was at Comic-Con, so I ended up actually putting them in my bag for most of the day, but they did really add a cool component to the costume, so maybe if I just super glue them together, then it won't keep falling apart. And then on top, I also wore this jean jacket. This is a jean jacket that I already owned, but I had got it at a thrift store a while back. And then I added a bunch of pins that I also got from a thrift store to kind of make it look a little bit more Tank Girl style. And then on top, I also wore these goggles. These are actually part of a costume that my dad wore a couple years ago for Halloween, part of a steampunk costume, but I thought they looked really awesome for Tank Girl as well. So here's a closer look at the pins. I have this bumblebee pin, a pokey pin from Gumby, and then I have a pin from the Thermals, which is one of my favorite bands of all time, and then a couple other pins that I got over the years. And yeah, so that's it for my Tank Girl costume. Again, this was such a fun costume to put together because you can be really creative with it and kind of mix and match lots of pieces. And you could probably use a lot of stuff that you already own and just kind of make it your own. This costume was really, really important and special for me because I don't usually go out of the house without a wig. So this is the first time that I really left the house without a wig and like went to an event. Technically, I'm still wearing a hairpiece, but it's still obviously very clear that I'm bald even though I'm wearing a hairpiece. So this was very, very exciting for me to do because it was definitely a fear that I had to conquer. I will admit that when I first got to Comic-Con, I was very, very nervous to be walking around. I think I wore a beanie to get there, and then when I got there, I took off the beanie and was kind of nervous at first, especially because I was at Comic-Con by myself, so it just felt like I had no protection. So for the first couple minutes, I was a little bit nervous, but then once I was there and everyone's in costume and everyone's having so much fun and everyone's complimenting each other's costumes, it just really puts you in a really awesome spirit, and that's part of the reason I love cosplaying so much. So this is kind of part of my way of getting over my fear of going out in public without a wig, is just to kind of like use cosplay as training wheels to get myself used to it. So again, if you want to see the full Tinkerl hair tutorial, I will link that on the screen or down below. And thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.